Hey, chicken, stop being such a hater. All you do is hate on everything. Stop being chicken, stop being such a hater, chicken. Stop it. Stop, chicken. Stop being a hater.
Comment section, 2018. Guys, today I want to talk to you about why you should not be summoning on the Legends Androids banner. I know a lot of you guys are probably going to be like, well, Chicken, it's basically a complete banner. It's currently meta relevant to some degree. Why would you not summon on this? Well, first and foremost, obviously, everybody wants the brand new 18. It's going to be a new blue sparking 18. If it has an Android Z ability, some Android-based players, you know, that mainly play Androids has, like, a really, really high amount of limit breaks on their Android team probably will go for Blue 18. I definitely think that that's a very good possibility, and maybe they'd want to go in for her. Again, you know, if she ends up being really good stat-wise, she ends up being really good Z-ability-wise, has an Android-based Z-ability and not a mono-element Z-ability, then there's definitely some potential there, and I absolutely will not rule that out. But if you are not a player that's either A, very, very new to the game, okay, like I'm talking literally like a week one player that's just getting into the game, or a player that's, you know, specifically playing Androids, whose favorite characters are Androids, who only wants to play Androids, I would recommend against summoning on this banner. I haven't even seen the stats on this character yet. I have no idea how good she's going to end up being. So why would I recommend against summoning on this banner? Well, I think that a lot of you guys are probably aware of what characters got confirmed the other day. As you guys know, I made a video on this a few days ago. I knew that Goku Black got confirmed. Well, turns out it's not Zamasu that's going to be coming alongside him. Apparently, it's going to be Super Saiyan 3 Goku and Kale, which is very odd in my opinion, but either way, you know, those are definitely confirmed characters. They might not be coming in the next few weeks, but they definitely will come sooner rather than later. And that's important to take into account here because this banner is not going to eclipse that banner, okay? These are trap banners. The Legends Saiyans banner was an obvious trap, okay? Legends Androids is a less obvious trap, but it's still a trap, okay? Because next month will be insane. 2 weeks from now even is going to be insane, okay? But next month we're probably getting Vegito. All signs are literally pointing towards us getting Vegito when the Christmas event does come out, when the holiday event comes out, whatever they're going to call it, you know. In every single Bandai game, every single gacha that they've made, they have always celebrated Christmas to a ridiculous degree. It's literally like the second biggest event in the entire year, the entire 12 months. Other events that are possibly that relevant, I'm gonna say maybe the anniversary, and I think that probably I want to say even halfway through the year with the 6 months, you know, that's also usually going to be a pretty big celebration. But you know, a year, I mean, that's a big deal. The anniversaries are always absolutely massive. But with that said, Christmas and just generally the holidays are going to be absolutely massive, guys. They're going to be absolutely ridiculous. And you would be a fool if you didn't think we were going to get something absolutely stupid on a banner around the time of, you know, Christmas or just a few weeks before whenever they do start up the holiday events. So just please, guys, please, just call me a hater down in the comments. Do whatever you need to do, but don't summon on this banner, okay? Just don't summon on this banner. Please, I don't want to laugh at you and say I told you so, but if you make those comments, if you go down and you're like, Chicken, you're a hater, you know, like a lot of people do, believe it or not, if you don't believe me, okay, go down to these comment sections, read the comments. There's a lot of people that just straight up call me a hater because I don't like a lot of banners on this game, because specific banners are way, way better quality-wise than other banners. Again, I'm going to reiterate here that we still can see Goten right towards the top of the ladder here. Obviously, we see, you know, Janemba regen teams and obviously Gogeta also, you know, making a huge splash in the game. But we still see Goten very viable towards the top of the pack. Take that how you will. That's the last banner that I've recommended going deep on, other than the Gogeta Janemba banner, which I recommended spending some on as well. Now, I will recommend, as soon as, again, it happens, I will recommend spending on another banner. But for the time being, I think, guys, we really need to be saving up our Chrono Crystals. We need to make sure that we are not falling for these trap banners, because they are not going to be worth the Chrono Crystals in even the short run, like a month from now, okay? They're not going to be worth it. This is a trap. These are meant to just sort of tease you with the thought of, hey, you know, you could compete right now if you got these characters right at this very moment. And then all of a sudden, a month from now, there's going to be crazy new characters coming out left and right. And you guys are going to be wishing you saved your Chrono Crystals. And they're going to have all these deals for probably, like, I want to say $25 for 3,000 Chrono Crystals or some crazy stuff like that. And you're going to be spending a bunch of money. Your wallet's going to be very angry at you. And you're just going to be like, I wish I took Chicken's advice and saved my Chrono Crystals and didn't fall for those trap banners. And you know what? I'm not going to say I told you so unless you comment about it down in the comments section below. But you guys know who you are. If you've fallen for trap banners in the past, you know exactly how it is, okay? One single new character that's not even new, but is a new version of a pre-existing character, you guys don't need that. Let's be honest here. You know, maybe 18 is your favorite character. Maybe androids are your favorite tag, your favorite team. That's a respectable decision. If you want to make the decision to drop a whole bunch of Chrono Crystals and get some more Z power for all of your androids, get the brand new 18, go for it, dude. I'm not going to stop you. Obviously, I can't anyways, but just think about it first, okay? Just think about it. There's going to be some crazy, just insane stuff that comes out in the next month. Do you want to save for it? Most people will probably want to save for it. Most people. Again, some people will not fall into that group, but it's the overwhelming majority would rather be summoning for Vegito right now than, you know, a new 18. Okay, and that's just the fact of the matter. There's going to be Vegito coming out sooner rather than later. We almost know this for certain. If not, it's going to be some other very highly anticipated character. It's going to be some crazy big event. They're going to give out a whole bunch of resources. Probably not a ridiculous amount of Chrono Crystals, but enough that we can summon a few times on whatever banner he ends up on. And then we're going to have a bunch of deals in the shop. And you won't have to buy them, most likely, if you save your Chrono Crystals until then. So just trust me on this one, guys. Please, I'm begging you. I know that the last few videos have not been very long. I'm going to get back to doing our normal content soon, but this one was made very, very late. So I wanted to just make this short video, talk to you guys about the new banner. It's not worth summoning on unless you're an Android fan and you just absolutely love the Androids and they're the only team you play and you have them all very high limit broken and you have no other characters in the game. Otherwise, don't summon on this banner. It is a trap banner. In the truest form of being a trap banner, it is a trap banner. A banner that is competitive right now, but will be outclassed very soon and force you to spend money on deals if you want to remain competitive. But that's going to be it for this one, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Really do appreciate it. As always, hoping for some really awesome new banners very, very soon. As you guys know, again, we have Goku Black, we have Super Saiyan 3 Goku, and we've got Kale coming very, very soon, as well as most likely Vegito, so keep an eye out for those. I will definitely be covering them as soon as I know that they're going to be added to the game, and I will see you in the next one. Until then, have a fantastic day. As always, let me know down in the comment section below if you have any ideas for future videos you'd like to see, and until the next one, guys, peace.